churches won't be closed. They will be open for people to go and pray privately, but all formal services will cease. Some churches will be able to provide live streaming for various parishioners and so on who have access to online. I spoke to him earlier today, and this is what he had to say.
We will not be going ahead with public scheduled services from them. We're encouraging people to pray at home, to get online. We're encouraging clergy to celebrate the morning and evening service and Holy Communion during the day as often as they can. We're encouraging churches to be open for informal prayer. Scheduled services don't happen. Go on being the church in how we act, how we love, and how we pray. And we call the country to a day of prayer and loving action next Sunday.
A positive approach, of course, but there must be disappointment. There's widespread disappointment, and there's concern because although funeral services and weddings will take place, because of the new protocols on hygiene and social distancing, they will have to be scaled down. I've already learned that the church next door to us, All Souls Loving Place, has a number of couples who are expecting to marry in April and May, and are considering whether they should change those services. The other thing that he said, the Archbishop, which was interesting, Justin Welby was an oil executive before he was ordained to the Christian ministry. He worked in Paris for something like 12 years. And he said that there is an absolute necessity for the government to support small businesses, particularly by investing in companies moderate and